I've done a video on this because I couldn't find any information generally around on the internet about how to perform these functions. In particular, here we are dealing with the laser alignment on the Gravograph LS800. This particular machine I got secondhand, didn't really know what I was getting into at the time, but one of the key things was not knowing how to align the mirrors. In particular, this unit here doesn't look obvious how it's adjusted. It's not like any of the cheap Chinese machines, but what you'll need is a 2mm Allen key, and there's actually an Allen key there, there's one here, and these two on the top are actually used to adjust the angle of the laser at this particular point. So these two here, basically you tighten one, loosen one off, and that will adjust the twist up and down, the vertical on the laser. And these two here will adjust the axis that it rotates on. Very, very fine movements. It's probably not as easy to do as the Chinese lasers, but once it's set, it seems to stick pretty well. The other one is the laser in the back here, or the mirror in the back here, sorry. And I'll go through that one in just a sec. So here we are at the back of the machine. I'll just point out some features. So there's this disc on top here, this round disc. That particular one is where the first mirror is mounted to. So that disc there can rotate a few degrees by loosening off these three screws around the outside. That can then rotate to go forward and away. On top of that, you have this one here. There's one in behind here, and then one in at the front here that will rotate the entire assembly on that axis. So that's your course adjustment. Once you have that, you can then use these two screws here in the top. There's the one in the center and then one right next to it. So the one in the center, if you do up that one, it will actually pull the lens up, and doing up this one here will push the lens back down. So they compete against each other. And so it's important that one is loosened off before the other one's tightened. Otherwise, you potentially cause damage. Now, don't use these too much. They're only for extremely fine adjustment. Looking at the internal mirror assembly, it's basically you're flexing a cut in the aluminium. So if you adjust it too much, it'll snap off and then you're going to be in big trouble. So when it comes to aligning that first mirror, this is the hole here. You're looking at getting the laser through. Now, I actually 3D printed this device here, that pokes in there to be able to put a bit of tape across it so you know exactly where the laser's hitting. That's just to assist with the alignment. I also done another one on the third mirror just to help know exactly where the laser's firing, because it's not overly easy to tell. So here we have the third mirror. Now this one, for as far as I can tell, is not really adjustable. There are four screws here which secure this plate to the main mechanism, but there doesn't seem to be any adjustment. If it is, it's extremely minor, but there's nothing precision about it like there is with the second mirror housings and whatnot. Now what I've done here is I've 3D printed this little cover here just to make it easier to put tape over that and know exactly where the laser's hitting to make sure it's in line with the center of this mirror here. One thing I did also want to mention is I actually discovered once I started playing with this, the z-axis would actually twist on the rail. I wasn't sure why, and I've been a bit nervous about pulling this machine apart because I didn't want to mess things up, because there's no guides or service manuals or anything for these machines. So everything I do, I'm a bit nervous about. But this particular one, I ended up having to take off this front assembly, and there's two screws that actually go into the block on the linear rail that sits behind here. And one of those was completely loose, so this whole assembly would move and cause issues. So I've gone in, tightened them up, put some Loctite on them as well to make sure that stays in alignment. So one other thing I wanted to mention as well is actually how to get this thing to fire the laser without having to run any program or anything through it. Now I can do that now, but this machine is quite loud, so unfortunately I'll have to talk over the fans. But I'll give you a demonstration of how to actually fire the laser. I probably won't in this particular case actually fire the laser, but it's pretty clear instruction on how to do it. So here, to fire the laser, we first have to turn the machine on. Now I do have the covers down, but I've still got that panel removed over there. So we'll turn this machine on, And then what we do, once it shows up with the Gravograph text, we push the cancel button. So now I've pushed the cancel button. We screw down to realign machine. And then align red pointer. And then it asks you for what power. I was using about 10. The advantage with 10 is you can do a shorter pulse, which gives you a smaller spot on the painter's tape. So let me go tick. And what it will do is it'll actually move the machine now. It actually moves it to, it'll home it and then move it to the middle of the bed. There we go. So it's over to the middle of the bed. So now what you can do, you can actually just use the normal adjustment buttons to move the carriage over to where you want it to. So in this case, I'm doing it to the top right, so the closest to that back, the first mirror. And from there, what you actually do is you actually push the red eye button. So that will actually, you'll hear the laser sort of wind up, makes a high pitch noise, and then it'll fire. So the first time you fire it, it will take a little bit longer because it seems to sort of has to tickle the laser a bit first, I think. But once that's done, then basically you'll push this, that you'll hear the click to turn off the red eye laser, which will then fire the actual CO2 laser. The longer you hold it down, the more it will burn. So the shortest time possible, you push that and that'll fire the laser. So fire the laser. That's fired the laser. All right, and then it gives you the option to like adjust where the red pointer is landing. But obviously we don't actually want to adjust the laser pointer. So from there, what I found was you have to sort of move it a little bit first. You just have to give it like a coordinate. But then if you hit cancel, it goes back to the point where you can move the carriage again. So that's now moving all the way to the front right. If you don't hit that cancel, then it won't let you move it again and it won't fire the laser again. So once you've got it back in the position where you want, then you can hit the red eye button again and keep burning, moving the carriage around and getting to the right spot, and then basically just cancel out of all this when you're done. It will then boot the machine. So there you have it. So contrary to a lot of information that's on the internet, with these particular ones, you can manually fire the laser without the need for software or drawing a square or whatever in each corner of the table. I found that to be really hard, and this method's much, much easier. You can just fire the laser at a low power whenever you want without actually moving the carriage at the time, which could affect your alignment and things like that, your testing. So hope you found this helpful. Let me know if there's any other information about this machine. I'm far from an expert. I literally just bought this on a whim, got it up and running again, and was just grateful that I could. There is very little information about these to hobbyists as such. So they're targeted for businesses. They're a high volume design. They're designed to run all day, every day for a business and a commercial application, not for average home hobbyist use. So hope this helps.